Welcome student, my name is Swapna Singh and today we are discuss about the pharmaceutical powder. Rest of the topic we will discuss today. So the next point or next topic in pharmaceutical powder, that are dispensing of powders involving special problems. So there are various kind of substances we are using for the preparation of pharmaceutical powder, like volatile substances, like hygroscopic substances or delicocent substances. So based on this, based on all these substances, we faces some special problems. So first problem, that is for volatile substance. So volatile substances, they certain vegetable powder contains volatile oils. So they prevent to prevent the loss of volatile oils, these vegetable drug must be powdered lightly in a mortar. So also menthol, camphor and essential oils take place incorporation in powder, and finally product pack with double wrapping. Next is hygroscopic powder or delicocent powder. Hygroscopic, that means which can retain the moisture. So they can absorb moisture from atmosphere and called hygroscopic powder. And delicocent powder, they absorb the moisture and convert into the solution, that are known as delicocent powders. So all these two kind of powder have difficulties in compression, like ammonium chloride, ammonium citrate, pepsin, phenobarbital, sodium iodide, etc. So these all are the kind of hygroscopic powder and delicocent powder. So such substances that are usually provide in granular form in order to expose less surface area to atmosphere and avoid convert into fine powder. So such powder should be double wrapped in packing. Next is effervescent powder. So effervescent powder, some crystalline substances liberates water of crystallization partly or wholly on exposure to humid atmosphere, like citric acid, caffeine, ferrous sulfate, etc. So this kind of problem overcome by mixing or incorporated with inert substances or using anhydrous subsalts. Next is next problem we can see in eutectic mixture. So first one is liquid. So in some precipitation, the liquid medicaments are also incorporated with powder. So in that case, if liquid quantity is small, so it may be triturate with equal amount of powder, then the reset of the ingredient are incorporated in small proportion with continuous stirring. And next is potent drug. So the substance having a maximum dose of less than 60 mg and the poisonous substances, so they are called potent drug, and it should be difficult to weigh on dispensing balance. So for that kind of drug, firstly potent drug incorporated with diluent such as lactose before weigh, then dispense following powder in 5 powder packets. Examples of potent drug like codeine phosphate, so 10 mg, in that case weigh 100 mg of codeine phosphate and 900 mg of lactose mixed with ascending order with the help of spatula. So out of 1 gram of triturate, weigh 100 mg of each powder contains 10 mg of codeine phosphate and pack in powder paper. So next is granular powder. Granular powder is some solid medicaments which are required to administer in orally in large dose, and it is not possible to convert into tablet or capsule because a large number of them will be required to take single dose. And these medicaments are difficult to dispense in powder form because it's better, it is nauseous in taste and it is unpleasant taste. So in this case, solid medicaments mix with sweetening agent, flavoring agent or coloring agent with suitable granulating agent to motion the powder and to make them coherent mass. Then pass through sieve number 10 and make granules and dry in hot air oven 860 degrees Celsius. And after the drying, pass through sieve number 20 and pack into the wide mouth container. So nowadays, antibiotics like erythromycin, ampicillin, etc. These all are the antibiotics that are available in granular powder because they are unstable in liquid form. Next is effervescent granules. Effervescent granules, that means when they contact in when they come in contact with the water, so they will release carbon dioxide. So this kind of medicament granules are prepared for internal use. So in that kind of medicament, firstly mixed with citric acid or tartaric acid or sodium bicarbonate with sweetening agent. So when they come in contact with the water, they release the carbon dioxide to mask the bitter taste or saline taste of drug. Also, carbon dioxide stimulates the flow of gastric juice and helps in the absorption of medicaments. So there are two kind of method for preparation of effervescent granule. First one is heat method and second one is weight method. So first we go through the heat method. So in heat method, firstly, porcelain dish make hot on water bath before transferring the powder. And after once water bath become hot, transfer all the medicament with citric acid and other ingredients. In that state, citric acid liberates the water and produce damp mask. So in that case, heating state takes 1 to 5 minutes, and then damp mask pass through sieve and dry it in hot air oven at 60 degrees Celsius temperature. After drying this powder, finally packed in airtight container. Next is weight method. So in weight method, the ingredients are firstly mixed with alcohol to produce the coherent mass. See, in heat method, we prepare the damp mass, and in weight method, we prepare the coherent mask. This is the difference between heat method and weight method. In heat method, we add the medicament in citric acid and other ingredient, but in weight method, the ingredients are mixed with alcohol to produce a coherent mask. And the produced mask pass through sieve number 10 or sieve number 8 and dry it in a hot air oven at 60 degrees Celsius temperature. After the drying, the dried granules are again passed through sieve to break the lump which may be formed during drying. So finally, the prepared granules are packed in airtight containers. Next is the mixing of powder. So for the mixing of powder, there are 5 different techniques. First one is spatulations. Second is trituration. Third one is geometric dilution. Next is shifting and tumbling. So spatulation, that means mixing the powder with the help of spatula on a paper or a sheet. This is spatulation. This is very simple technique for the mixing of powder. Firstly, we take any paper, or we can choose any sheet where all the powder or dry ingredients are placed, and by the help of spatula we can mix easily. Next is trituration. So trituration is used for reduced of size or for mixing of powder. So trituration will perform in a mortar and pestle, in which drugs are firstly placed on the mortar, and by the help of pestle we can mix the powder, and it is also used for the size reduction. Next is geometric dilution. So geometric dilution is always important for the potent drug. Next is shifting. So shifting the powder that are mixed by passing through shifters. Shifters are the instrument for mixing of the powder preparation. Next is tumbling. Tumbling is the process of mixing powder in a large container rotated by an electric motor. And these kind of blender are widely used in industry as large volume of powder mixers. So these all are the equipments which are used for the mixing of powder. Packing of powder. So for the powder packing, there is only one method is available, that is double wrapping. In this method, powders are wrapped using two different type of paper. So first one is outer paper, second one is inner wrapping. So outer paper is plain paper, while inner wrapping is of gelatine paper. So these two different type of paper we can wrap or we can pack the powder. This is known as double wrapping. So this is all about the pharmaceutical powder and its manufacturing in industries. Thank you.